Hey, Turtle Nerds, welcome back to another video. It's been a hot minute, but let me explain. If you're just here for the video for the brackish versus freshwater debate, just skip to this little timestamp here. Let me go ahead and explain why I've been missing. First off, spring break, I went to Jamaica. That was like a full week out of the way. There was another week where I believe I don't have that many excuses, except for the fact that I got a job and basically every day I have something to do. I get to sleep in at the latest 9 o'clock, like all week, because Monday through Friday I have classes and then Saturday and Sunday I work at a pet store around here. So that's sort of where I've been putting a lot of my free time, and I've needed that sort of income in order to supplement basically my life because I have student loans to pay for. And the way that I do it is I pay a little bit now, so I don't have to pay a whole lot, like thousands of dollars more later on in life. So I figure it's better off that I get a job and pay a little bit now than have to pay a whole bunch later on. Anyway, you guys don't really care about that. That's just what I've been doing, and I felt really bad. Also, my computer is sort of a piece of garbage, and when I would connect my phone, I was finally ready to edit this video. I connected my phone, connected it to my computer, it no longer works. So that was a big bummer. So now I'm using a really funky, annoying way basically to get this footage from my phone, which is what I record with, onto my computer. So it's sort of a pain in the butt, but I'm doing it because I love it and I miss you guys. And I feel really badly that I haven't made a video. Please don't hate me. I just sort of get busy. You guys know I'm in college. I had a whole bunch of tests and projects and things that built up. Then I had spring break. And then my computer was being annoying, and then I got a job, and then I was like, something had to sort of take a sort of step back. Something, I wasn't able to sustainably do a job, school, and videos basically all at the same time, and a social life, and I'm actually in a club, so I couldn't really do all of that at once. So therefore, something had to take a step back. It happened to be videos. I feel bad, and now I am back. I promise you. I've considered making a Patreon. That way, it sort of gives me more incentive to make videos. Let me know what you guys think, if you would support me, if you would not. Totally up to you guys. I'm not here asking for handouts. I want to hear from you. I would be sure to update it, put all the videos on there, at least before I put them on YouTube. Give live Q&As, inside access, whole bunch of exclusive media and videos of these guys that you wouldn't normally get on this channel. So let me know what you guys think. Anyway, let's go ahead and get onto the video. So there are three main stages of salinity that water can take on. The first one is fresh water. The second is brackish water. And the third is salt water. Now, most people know all about fresh water. They know that we need it to survive. Most organisms need it to survive. And it basically is water with zero salt content or very little to undetectable levels of salt. Now, salt water is salty water. And the way that we actually measure that is using a refractometer or a hydrometer or I think they go by a couple different names and they are different, but I bought this, I'll write the name of it and put a link down below. I bought it off Amazon. I love it, it works super well. I highly recommend this if you're gonna dabble into brackish water. So fresh water reads on that little scale 1.000. That is completely fresh water. Now salt water, I believe, is 1.025 and above. That's measuring the specific gravity, which changes as you add salt. So 1.025 and above is usually like salty water. By the way, these variables change. Some people say it's different than others. This is just what I have personally heard. Now, anything between 1.000 and 1.025 is brackish water. It is a very wide range, and for terrapins, they can definitely take some varying salinities. But for the sake of this video, I'm gonna talk about basically where these guys are gonna be most comfortable and where they are going to require fresh water to drink from. So now that we know what brackish water is exactly, let me explain basically how terrapins work in the wild. Diamondback terrapins are born and raised in brackish water in their native ecosystems. They sort of habit these estuaries that are where river mouths meet the ocean, and it's where fresh and salt water mix. This is where they usually tend to live, in these marshy sort of wetlands. Now, if you were to take one of these terrapins that's accustomed to brackish water and put it in fresh water, it would actually grow a fungus over a very short period of time and die. So you cannot convert a terrapin from brackish water to fresh water. You actually can, but it's really, 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 really difficult, and I have no idea how to do it. Please don't ask. I have no clue. I just actually discovered that it is possible, but it's really difficult and really expensive and time consuming. Don't bother. Now, if a terrapin is born and raised in fresh water, it can stay in fresh water for its whole life. Like these guys. I got them when they were all hatchlings, except for El Tigre, and I raised them in fresh water, and that's where they've been staying, and they've been doing fine. Now, I'm just gonna sort of go over some quick pros and cons of keeping them in fresh water. So terrapins in fresh water don't need access to fresh water separately because they're living in it. It also allows for them to have other tank mates, like other fish. Most types of fish are not really salt tolerant, therefore you can't keep them in full brackish water with terrapins. Now, the issue with fresh water is that it actually gets dirtier a lot quicker than brackish water would. I actually didn't entirely realize this until I took a look at when I kept this tub with a little bit of salt and when I didn't, and boy, did it get dirty really quickly. I will show you guys right now. This was just an hour ago before I just did a water change, and I forgot to put in salt because I normally do it the day after I do a water change so the water can heat up. Oh my lord, did it get dirty quickly. This is not to say that the water won't get gross with salt added. It just means that the salt will kill off a lot of pathogens and things in the water that would normally cause it to foul up a lot. That's one of the pros of keeping brackish water and one of the cons of fresh water. Fresh water allows more little diseases and parasites and icky things to enter the water. So let's go ahead and move on to brackish water. Keeping your terrapins in brackish water can help with keeping funguses off of their skin, because if you keep them in fresh water, you really need to keep that water pristine and clean. Salt will help keep the fungus off of their skins and off of their shell. Therefore, it allows you a little bit of leniency with how dirty your enclosure can get before needing to clean it out. But it does not entirely eliminate the need to do water changes or clean out your filter. You still need to do that, it just sort of expands the amount of time of when you need to do so. I also personally believe that brackish water helps with any shell problems. When terrapins are shedding their scutes, if they have issues shedding them and they have retained scutes, what happens to the bark on this log is a lot like what happens to the scutes on the shell. If it sort of dries out and then gets all hard and crusty and then gets soaked in water and then gets dried again and then continues to get wet and then dry and then get wet again, sort of the salt will build up underneath and start to lift the scute off of the shell and sort of help to pull it off and help them shed. That is just my personal belief, and it also helps keep fungus that can grow between the shed scute and the new scute. If it's retained, it can help sort of get rid of some of the fungus underneath there as well. An issue with keeping brackish water is that you do need to give them some access to fresh water at least once a week. Usually though, if you're feeding in a separate enclosure, simply feed them in fresh water and they'll be able to drink then. In the wild, terrapins get access to fresh water when it rains. There's, because brackish water is more dense, there's brackish water here, and then the fresh water goes along the surface. There's a very small amount along the surface. Terrapins will come up and drink there or go into puddles on land and drink the fresh water from there. As far as values for what salinity level is what, where is brackish, where is fresh, up to 1.008, terrapins do not need access to fresh water, but they still get some of the benefits of having slightly salty water. This is personally what I do. It sort of keeps the fungus off of their skin. It allows you a little bit more time between water changes and keeps the water a little bit more sterile. But you also don't need to give the terrapins access to fresh water because it's not so salty that they can't be drinking that water. Needless to say though, I still feed my terrapins in fresh water just because I'm paranoid. You can keep terrapins in more salty water, but I would only go up to about 1.015. Anything above that, and you're starting to get into like salt water, which is not necessary, and it's actually not healthy for your terrapins. So let's sort of get into what sort of salt I use for these guys. There's no real exact science to this, folks. Some people convert their terrapin slowly and add a little bit more salt to the water slowly over time. I do suggest doing this, but my guys are actually used to a small amount of salt up to 1.008, but usually 1.005. Therefore, if you want to add salt to your terrapin's enclosure, just add some water softening pellets. Make sure that they are at least 99% pure. I use the Diamond Crystal brand. It's $5 for a 40-pound bag. Grab some handfuls of salt. I toss them in and slowly measure with my little hydrometer, refractometer, whatever thingy, until it reads the proper amount. It's awesome because I get the benefits of having a little bit of salt without needing to give these guys fresh water every week. Not to mention, all of the fish survive and they can tolerate a little bit of saltiness. Even my goldfish down there, that goldfish can actually take a little bit of salt in the water. It's quite interesting. So as far as exactly how you're gonna wanna introduce the salt into the enclosure, let's see. So in order to add the salt to the terrapin enclosure, what I'm going to go ahead and do is get a small measuring cup. Let me see where I can find one. Take a small measuring cup. I have this empty can here. And you're gonna want to measure out one cup of this salt per exact science. Who? I can't hear you over the sound of me dumping salt in this enclosure. You don't need to make it an exact science. Just don't add too much. And if you add too much, just pull some salt out. Pull a couple buckets of water out, add fresh water, and dilute it out. Seriously, your terrapins are not gonna die. They're not gonna freak out. Just add some salt if you want to go a slight brackish water route, and I promise you they will be fine. So now I'm pretty much gonna wait for all of that salt to dissolve into the water and then go ahead and get my little tool and measure it out and show you exactly how this thing works. Super easy, super cheap, and I personally love this thing. Oh, I forgot to mention one other reason that I was not editing videos was because I was editing a video for the Turtle Survival Alliance, who are one of the lead conservationist groups of Colonian species across the world. So that was super cool and super fun. I may also be doing another video for them, so that's super cool and super exciting. I forgot to mention, you guys can add salt to your terrapin's enclosure as early as you want in their life or as late. I personally recommend raising them the first year in freshwater and then deciding to add salt if you want to. You don't have to add salt if you don't want to, and if you can keep that water really clean and really pristine. Some people swear that brackish water is completely necessary for terrapins. Scientifically proven, it is not. So that's pretty much gonna do it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for being patient with me. I've missed you all a whole bunch. To anybody new here, welcome to the channel. It's a blast. And I want to thank you all again for watching. I'll see you all in the next video. And please give me a comment down below. Tell me what's going on with your life. Tell me how your turtles are. If you have any questions, contact me. Follow me on all the good stuff. And I will see you guys in the next one.